Hi, I'm Mark Whitaker, technical consultant with Lenovo Smart Collaborations Department. Today, I want to show you the multiple camera view enabled by Microsoft Teams release 5.2, which was released recently. The best way to experience this is with the Lenovo ThinkSmart Bar 180 located at the front of the room in conjunction with three ThinkSmart cameras around the room. This is an excellent feature for any size space where you might want to include a view from multiple vantage points to allow you to see everybody's face within a meeting. Joining me here today from the great faraway land of downstairs is none other than the great Sean Langley. Sean, why don't you tell us about what you see on your systems?
Certainly, Mark, and hi everyone. Great to be joining you today. And it's a bit chilly down here. I'm on the second floor, but more importantly, let's look at what multiple camera view looks like to the far end participants running Teams desktop. So currently in the moment, I've got the four camera view split, if you like. So I've got to, I can see very easily which view I want to pick from. But then if you want to get a more focused view, I might move to camera one or the bar 180, as you were highlighting on the call. So I can see everyone at the table looking like very important executives there staring me down. If there's a conversation happening in the room, and that's the beauty of camera view, or if I want to zoom in on the whiteboard or something like that, I can just simply toggle between these four camera views to whichever one I or anyone else on the far end feels is the most comfortable view to get from inside the meeting room.
So Sean, tell me, what is the remote experience like for this multiple camera view?
Well, first and foremost, it's important to point out that everyone that's dialing in on Teams desktop has this capability, and they can each pick their own camera feed. So I'm looking at the view of you now straight on, but other participants on the call could be looking at the side on view or maybe the rear camera view or something like that. So it's independent to each user as they dial in. And that's the whole point. So you, as the remote or far end participant, if you like, you pick the view that suits you best.
One other thing I'd like to point out is that this feature can be turned off on a meeting by meeting basis. One of the key reasons why you might want to consider that would be a security feature. For instance, right now, our whiteboard camera can capture people walking by in the hallway with the glass walls we have in this room. If you didn't want to see who was walking by, maybe you shut the feature off. So it can be an additional security feature point as well.
I think it's great because that gives in-room users choice. Because say you're in that meeting room and there was just two of you in there, there's no need to have four cameras active. You just go back to your regular camera view and you just pick which is going to be the primary.
Sean, thank you so much for joining us here today. I really appreciate you coming at us all the way from downstairs. And thank you all for watching the video today. Until next time, I hope to see you then. Lenovo, Lenovo.